Manipulation techniques. How to influence people with mind control, body language, persuasion, NLP, and dark psychology. Written by Adam Martin. Narrated by Adam Reeder. Introduction. Manipulation is using people's emotions and behavioral traits deliberately to obtain what is desired. Manipulators use their ability to understand others and get what they want by using trickery, misdirection, persuasion, charm, and coaxing. In the mind of the manipulator, he or she thinks, "I have the ability to change people's behavior and let them give me what I want." Skilled manipulators can even come out with a situation when they get caught trying to use other people for their advantage. A manipulator has a tendency to create a certain level of strain in a situation. They use multiple techniques to mold their personality according to their goals. A manipulator can make you feel on top of the world, or the worst person on this planet. It all depends on how that manipulator wants you to act. Manipulation, as a concept, involves two parties. One is the manipulator, and the other is the manipulated. While manipulators are extremely aware of their surroundings, some personalities tend to ignore that. People who are emotionally vulnerable or don't have a clear mindset tend to get manipulated. Generally speaking, everyone manipulates without knowing. Lying or hiding the complete story are a few common ways of manipulation. However, manipulators live these tactics as the way of their lives. They use various tactics as their tools to fool you into doing what they want. That's why you tend to understand all types of manipulation, and more importantly, learn how to address it positively in different aspects of your life. If you aren't aware enough, manipulators can use many techniques to control you. They change their approach depending on the victim's personality. So they first observe you and learn your core personality traits. At the core, you can be a loving person, a lonely person, naive or too confident. With personality observation, manipulators create their tactic to attack you. Here are different types of manipulation that you need to become aware of. 1. Hiding the complete story. You can notice this in your office parties and other conversations taking place around you. There are people who hide certain portions of stories in order to create a diversion. The listener of the story gets to know what the manipulator wants him to know. What if a colleague in your office tells you how others are bitching about you? It is possible that you're getting half of the side of the story. But if you're unaware of manipulation, this half story can trigger emotions like anger and hatred, and you end up doing something that you regret. When a manipulator uses a half story, they don't lie. They just avoid telling a certain portion so that you see a picture of their creation. The tactic behind this method is to stay on the safe side. If exposed, the manipulator can simply say that he or she has explained nothing but the truth, and in doing so, you risk facing humiliation due to your wrong actions. 2. Lying. Generally, people lie when they are scared or want to get out of an unwanted situation. But a manipulator's lie is different. Their lies always have a purpose or an end goal. In fact, they don't even have to plan before lying. They can plan their next lie while having a conversation with you. Depending on what they want, manipulators can choose different lies to make you their victim. It is a blend of thrill and excitement they feel while trying to play your personality. Love and charm. Narcissistic manipulators use love and charm to control you. This behavior is majorly visible in love relationships between partners. You get hooked and think that your partner loves you the most. They charm and create an illusion of a perfect relationship. These people always want something from you. When love has built the foundation, the manipulator uses that to control you. They can ask for things, money, or just play with your emotions. The goals depend on the personality of the manipulator. Some people have the disorder to love and then hurt their partners. The roots of the behavior leads back to their own previous experiences. To spot the manipulation of love, you need to notice who is making decisions in your relationship. Do you feel afraid of your partner when making a personal choice? Has it become your habit to get your partner's approval on everything? Are you doing things that you wouldn't do otherwise? These questions can help you decipher love manipulation in your daily life. 4. Changing behavior frequently. This is different than changing personality traits according to a victim. A manipulator, many times, may showcase a behavioral change towards the same person again and again. Now, you can think of all those people who seem different every time you meet them. This behavior is common in love relationships and boss and employee relationships as well. The manipulator wants you to stay malleable and out of balance. So one minute, he or she can look happy and swiftly become angry for no valid reason. However, they make you think that their behavioral switch has a legitimate reason. Your boss can start shouting angrily just for a single typo in your report. Similarly, a manipulative partner can come home with a different mood every day. We as humans understand other people's personalities before socializing. You feel more comfortable around a person who you know well instead of a stranger. But manipulators use their mood swings to keep you scared and afraid of them. You feel unaware of their personalities and try to please them. 5. Denying accusations. A manipulator can deny things very impressively. If you accuse them of something, they confidently present a believable story. The confidence combined with an impressive story makes you believe them. Denying accusations is the simplest form of manipulation. In fact, this is the first tactic that manipulators use in their early ages. A kid with manipulative tendencies usually denies things with confidence and makes stories to justify their case. 6. Punishments. Punishment is a disciplinary action to control other people's behavior. This is also a manipulation technique that gives your control to a manipulator. Physical violence, shouting, and nagging are the visible techniques of a manipulation. Apart from that, you can also get emotionally punished with the silence of a person or mental abuse. A manipulator can attack your emotional vulnerabilities to make you feel bad. They keep on doing it until you start behaving exactly the way they want. Such manipulation is seen in marriages a lot. One partner uses physical and mental abuse to control the other. Also, you can notice these manipulation systems in a parent-kid relationship. A manipulative kid can use the silent treatment to control his or her mother. 7. Blaming for overreaction. Is there a person who makes you feel bad about yourself? That person can be a manipulator. Using the blame game allows a manipulator to put you on the faulty side of every conversation. If you point out their actions, they blame you for overreacting. They say that you are reacting way too much for a very small thing. This way, they become the victim and you end up feeling bad about your own actions. 8. Victim targeting. You are the victim, but the accuser makes you defend yourself in front of others. This way, the manipulator masks his or her own wrongdoings by shifting the focus towards you. The manipulator does it all in front of you, but you feel out of control of the situation. 9. Playing the victim. Have you ever helped people whom you never liked as a person? Then it's possible that you were used with the manipulation technique. Manipulators play victim from time to time to gain compassion and sympathy. Their end goal is always to use you in some way. However, not every victim is a manipulator. Some are genuinely hurt and require your support. But manipulators can use your helping nature to get what they want. 10. Too much positive attention. The corporate world is filled with such manipulators nowadays. People use expensive presents, give money and praise to lure you towards them. Excessive charm and too much attention are used for people who seek approval and like getting praised. Manipulators judge personalities and give them too much attention to satisfy your emotional needs. Positive attention works if you are emotionally vulnerable. For instance, if you mention society before taking every action, it tells a manipulator about your approval-seeking nature, your high-class dressing sense and money-focused behavior. Also gives a signal to manipulators. They start giving you the royal treatment and manipulate in the process. 11. Diversions. Shifting situations and conversations are also manipulation techniques. You feel you know what's going on, but suddenly a person changes the whole picture. If that happens in your life frequently, then there is a manipulator around you. He or she wants you to stay confused while they get twist situations in their favor. When in a group conversation, a manipulator plays the role of a narrator. If a conversation goes against his or her plan, they immediately shift the topic to something else. These manipulators become the kings and queens of office politics. 12. Isolation. Manipulation is difficult when you are consulting your family and friends on the same topic. Hence, a manipulator tries everything to isolate you from other people. This doesn't have to be a literal isolation. The manipulator can tell you to keep things a secret from everyone. Once you agree to that, he or she can twist your behavior easily. Chapter 1. Two major categories of manipulation. Covert manipulation combines all the invisible techniques of manipulation. You can't see the psychological attacks of an abuser until it's done. This type of manipulation is intentional, and the abuser prepares to harm you in a psychological way. You think that all the wrong things are happening accidentally, but the abuser knows what you feel. The extreme covert manipulators are known as psychopaths and narcissists. They follow a systematic emotional attack to break your confidence and control your realities, and you end up as their puppet. In covert manipulation, the abuser shows you a twisted reality. This misguided reality brainwashes you and ruins your ability to make correct decisions. Then, the abuser guides as he or she pleases. Overt manipulation includes all those techniques which the victim can experience and notice. So the physical, verbal, and sexual abuses come into this category. It is a situation where you have a higher tendency of knowing that you're being manipulated. But some folks may still end up not knowing what to do about it. Both overt and covert manipulation deserve to be on your watch list. That is for sure. And we will find out ways to deal with them later on. The different type of manipulators. According to the manipulation techniques, you can come across the following kinds of manipulators. The expert. I am better than you at everything. This person wants to stay on top of every situation. These manipulators are driven by their desire to attain a strong social dominance over others. Their personalities include a high ego, which they blend with their ability to locate vulnerable people. These people like to keep people who lack self-confidence, which serves their ego. Using insults and put-downs, these manipulators exploit the vulnerability of their victims. They are narcissistic, but hide their arrogance with fake politeness. At the core, these manipulators have self-doubts and shame. Manipulation becomes their technique to hide their own vulnerability. The perpetual victim. People hurt me and use me all the time. In every scenario, you find these manipulators showcasing themselves as victims, even if the situation has nothing to do with them. They find a way to become the victim. If you cut your fingers by mistake, this manipulator starts getting a headache and blames you for that. By becoming a victim, these manipulators cause fights and arguments around them. You might argue with others for this person, and they stay behind the scenes. And every argument or fight, this person will behave as a victim again. This gives power to emotionally control others and gain their sympathy at the same time. These manipulators seek more attention from their surroundings. You can see them feeling angry and emotionally distressed. They blame their shortcomings on others, hatred for them. They use ethics as their so many times and project paranoia about everything. strong dependence. Please follow my lead to save me from my life. These manipulators are strong and weak at the same time. They present themselves as a powerless creature, but they are very much in control from the inside. They like to depend on someone else for their needs. In order to gain that control, they show as if they are weak and unable to live on their own. Giving compliments is a secret weapon they use to obtain control over victims. The moment you judge them as inferior and try to help, they gain control over you. One by one, all their responsibilities become yours, and if you try to avoid them, they make you feel as if you are letting them down, like how others have. The angry beast. How dare you ask me that? It's not my fault at all. These manipulators won't let you blame them for anything. They keep people away by using anger as their guard. Teenagers usually showcase these tendencies for a while. However, they aren't aware of their behavior. On the other hand, a manipulator deliberately shows anger. In many relationships, one partner shows anger if asked about stealing behavior, increasing credit card bills, or cheating. No matter how politely you ask, their reply is always over the top. They constantly avoid confrontation and play the blame game with their partner. For example, a manipulator can blame the partner for his her affair, saying, "I had an affair because you weren't spending enough time with me." A strong denial is their key to keep doing what they want to do, so they can scream or physically abuse you if confronted strongly. The wrong well-wisher. "I am the only friend you have in the world. Others want to eat you alive." Lying, hiding, the complete story, and other manipulation techniques are valuable tools for these manipulators. They want to isolate you from family and friends by feeding lies in your mind. At the same time, they present themselves as your only well-wisher, who is on your side no matter what. Alliance creation is the way they live their lives. Their friendly nature doesn't allow you to figure out their true intentions. They gradually create a strong bond with their victim, keeping their nasty intentions hidden. Then the series of rumors begin, and the manipulator becomes the source of information for the victim. They hurt emotionally with their lies and trigger hatred and anger in their victim's mind. Friends, parents, and colleagues, anyone can be this manipulator in your life. For instance, between two close girlfriends, one can start spreading rumors about another character just because she has a crush on her friend's boyfriend. The truth twister. "Sorry, I think I have misinterpreted what you told me." Using half-truths, exaggerations, and lies, these manipulators gain control over their victims. They smartly alter the victim's words and turn them into reputation-harming rumors. When exposed, they simply deny and apologize by saying, "I misunderstood your words." These people want to feel superior in their group, even if they don't deserve it. Their friendly nature allows them to blend and bond with people to exploit their vulnerable sides. Gaining personal information is the first step they make, and then they create a misinterpreted story around that information. They have the capacity to justify their actions and play victim if confronted. The stubborn deniers. You are bad. I am good. Period. Filled with a vast amount of ego, these manipulators deny their own behavior and actions. They usually don't understand their own flaws and project their flaws in others. For example, such a manipulator can say, "You are a racist person," even when they have racist tendencies. They see their faults and think that the world has those faults. These manipulators blame their victims and even try to include the other people in their blame game. Their stubborn nature doesn't let them realize their own flaws. They actually believe that their actions and beliefs are always right. For example, such a manipulator will point out the laziness of their victim when he is the lazy one. In his mind, he will create justifications for his own laziness. The charming flirt. "I am gorgeous, so give me what I want." Attracting people and controlling them. That is how these manipulators operate. Their attractive looks become their weapon. Superficial in nature, these people feel more attractive than they actually are. They have to be the favorite person in every person's life. However, they only care about their needs and desires. Flirtatious nature and sexual triggers help these manipulators lure their victims. They want you to react to their flirtatious behavior in a positive way. These manipulators love creating tension among family members and friends. These manipulators never stop looking for new partners. They connect with current partners strongly, but keep looking for new potential partners. They don't believe in traditional relationship structures of society. In fact, when friendships and families break, it empowers these manipulators. They want to twist people's relationships and live life like a grand drama show. You are bad and I am good. Period. Filled with a vast amount of ego, these manipulators deny their own behavior and actions. They usually don't understand their own flaws and project those flaws in others. For example, such a manipulator can say you are a racist person, even when they have racist tendencies. They see their faults and think that the world has those faults. These manipulators blame their victims and even try to include other people in their blame game. Their stubborn nature doesn't let them realize their own flaws. They actually believe that their actions and beliefs are always right. For example, such a manipulator will point out the laziness of their victim when he's the lazy one. In his mind, he will create justifications for his own laziness. The charming flirt. "I am gorgeous, so give me what I want." Attracting people and controlling them, That is how these manipulators operate. Their attractive looks become their weapon. Superficial in nature, these people feel more attractive than they actually are. They have to be the favorite person in every person's life. However, they only care about their needs and desires. Flirtatious nature and sexual triggers help these manipulators lure their victims. They want you to react to their flirtatious behavior in a positive way. These manipulators love creating tension among family members and friends. These manipulators never stop looking for new partners. They connect with current partners strongly, but keep looking for new potential partners. They don't believe in traditional relationship structures of society. In fact, when friendships and families break, it empowers these manipulators. They want to twist people's relationships and live life like a grand drama show. Manipulation in advertising versus personal. Manipulation in advertising is a completely different thing compared to personal manipulation or persuasion. The question is, what are the differences between manipulation in advertising and persuasion, and how can it be described? In order to get the answer, we need to know how both advertising and personal manipulation works. In the advertisement world, manipulation works as a sudden choice-making weapon. When an advertisement reaches its potential client, it makes them react exactly the way the promoters or advertisers wanted, which is to make a quick decision driven by the manipulative trick they have displayed on the advertisement. Suppose there is a product called X. Advertisers know that what trick can make consumers crave a need or desire for the product X, which specialities are to display to make X more noticeable. Now, all the advertiser has to do is produce an advertisement imprinted with those affecting features of that certain product. This strategy results into a lot of sales and profits, but requires solid application and effort. This manipulation term is very popular among the business community all over the world and known as marketing manipulation. On the other hand, persuasion is based on a certain person's issues, conditions, and most importantly, depends on their circumstances. Persuasion influences a person's intentions, attitudes, motivations, behaviors, etc. These enables the persuader to anticipate others' actions, therefore to modify or tender others' actions according to his will. This tool can be used both in small confrontation and large number of gatherings, such as...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.